and welcome to this cabinet vision design tutorial. My name is Taylor and today I'm going to be showing you how to section the inside of drawers to create storage solutions for your clients. Maybe you've seen in the past a client bring in an image like one of these because they want to split up their drawer to be able to have better storage inside of the drawer. In this image we can see pots at the back, a divider and then the lids in front. That divider is going to keep it really nice and neat in there and stop the lids from falling over when the drawer is pulled in and out of the cupboard. So that's a really great solution lots of people love, and it does really improve the amount of storage that you can get in a drawer by organizing it in that way. And over here on the right hand side, I've got a big deep drawer underneath an oven where they want to obviously be storing their trays. And by including these vertical divisions in the drawer, they can keep the trays up on their side, which means they can see every single tray the minute that they open the drawer. If they wanted just a plain drawer to store trays in, the trays are all going to have to sit on top of each other, which means when they come to grab the specific tray they're looking for, they're probably going to have to pull out half a dozen trays onto the bench to find the one that they're looking for. Which is fine, but this is a much better storage solution for them. So let's jump over into cabinet vision and see how we can make this happen. Okay, so this is the kitchen that I'm going to be using. I've got a set of drawers here beside my stove, so that's the one I'm going to section. So to do this, I need to first double click, and this will bring me into the section view of the drawers. I'm on section face. And then from there, I right click on the drawer that I want to add the sections to, slide down to properties, and then across to drawer box, and then finally down to section drawer, which will bring up this drawer box section editor. So this is a plan view of the inside of my drawer. So you can see inside my drawer, I have 425mm going back and 901mm side to side. Is the internal space, all one big open space at the minute, like almost all drawers are. So let's imagine that we want to add the split for the pot and pan drawer here. So we want to add a split going across the drawer, close to the front. We want more room at the back for pots and less room at the front for the lids to sit vertically. So from there, I can use these buttons up the top here to add sections. So I've got a split opening horizontal, split opening vertical, multiple splits horizontal and vertical, and obviously a delete button to get rid of anything I might not want anymore, and zoom buttons as well. So I'm going to use this split opening horizontally button, and that is going to add a split in, but it's also automatically going to put that split equally in the drawer. So I need to move it so that I have a bit more room for my pots and pans. So I'm gonna guess that maybe I need about 300mm for pots and pans to sit, which will leave me then with just over 100mm for the lids to sit upright in. That's probably a good amount for now. Of course, you could get your clients to measure what size pots they have that they wanna include in there, but that's probably a pretty good split. So that's easy as that. We just hit okay to save it and okay again. And I'll show you what that's done. If we jump over to the 3D, got my drawer open. So if I tilt that up and spin it around, you can see that's just added a nice little split inside the drawer, room for the pots behind and room for the lids in front. So let's then look at doing this division system for trays or for chopping boards, things like that. Okay, so if I go back to section, again, right click, properties, across to drawer box, section drawer. So I need to get rid of this one that I have had in there previously. So I just click on it and then hit delete. And now I could use the single split opening and then, you know, add lots of them and move them around, but it's going to be so much quicker to use the multiple. So I'm going to click on that and it will ask me how many sections would I like it split into. Now, just to note, this isn't how many like actual pieces of board am I going to be adding. It's how many spaces in between each section are we adding. So let's go for, say, 6. We'll hit OK. So you can see that it's actually added 1, 2, 5 divisions to give me the 6 spaces that I want. And those are all nice and even, which is probably great for trays. Each one is about 137 millimeters wide, so that's probably great. So then we would hit okay, okay again. And again, if we just swivel that around, we can see lots of nice divisions there for trays or chopping boards to sit upright in. Cool. And then obviously lastly, if you did want to combine horizontal and vertical divisions, you can absolutely do that as well. So you could just hit, if we've got lots of parts that we want to delete, you can just hit the delete button without clicking on anything in particular, and it will ask if you want to erase all of the draw box parts, which means all of the divisions that you've put. So just hit yes and I'll get rid of everything. So say we wanted a division straight through the middle. Maybe we're going to have like oils or condiments or something like that in the drawer. So we probably would only need maybe 120 millimeters wide for that. But then we also want to add some multiple sections going back, probably 4 or so. Yeah, that's probably about right. So we've got about 95 by 120 millimeter sections. Maybe if we make it 100 by 100 sort of thing. So just these little sections, say for bottles of condiments to sit in beside the stove. So if we hit okay and okay again, go back to our 3D. So you can see most of the drawer's open, but we've got these little sections where maybe some bottles could stand in and it will stop them falling over as the drawer is pulled in and out. So you can really combine the sections as much as you want to create different storage for your clients. You can put in multiple, add and delete them is super easy to do. So I hope you found this video really helpful. Thank you for watching and I'll catch you in the next design tip.
Hey, thanks so much for watching. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this one, please be sure to like and subscribe. You can also check out our other videos that will help guide you on your path to becoming a cabinetry power user.